Hello and welcome to episode 5 of my Inktober series. Today I'm going to try out two things that I've never worked on before, which are painting a landscape and painting a building. So basically, my pieces are usually portraits. And I focused on that kind of piece because, number one reason, I didn't have time to fully practice everything else. And I'd rather feel confident about one thing than to know just a little about a bunch of stuff. And I don't think by any means that people who'd rather do it the other way around are wrong. I actually think that's the most effective way to go around it, but I simply do not identify with it. And number two, portraits are my favorite thing to see, so therefore I assumed it would also be my favorite thing to paint myself. So yeah, that's why I went for it, and of course I do like it a lot. If you check my Instagram page, you can confirm that 1 out of 5 posts are portraits, so yeah, that's what I'm always doing. But landscapes really enrich a piece, even if you take it just as background. And I think buildings can look as interesting as a portrait, because, I mean, an old castle for example, it surely holds 1,000 stories of 1,000 people who used to live there. So yeah, buildings are something that I really want to get a grasp into eventually. But like, landscapes can be really overwhelming because there are so many different objects and plants, shapes, buildings, animals, the clouds, the trees, sun, even the wind. Everything is there. Everything has a physical presence somehow. So to work on a landscape, you kinda need to have control over all those kinds of figures and structures, and for someone who's always painting portraits, that's kinda a lot of stuff. And then you have to use coloring and values and line art in a way that they all look like a part of the same environment, which I also have zero practice on. So yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, landscapes are the union of all kinds of things. And since I've always been focused on portraits, it's scary. Anyways, I think that it will be way easier for me to find out my way around these subjects if I do it digitally, but I still thought Inktober could be a good push, because after all, Inktober is about trying out new stuff, being it material-wise or object of study-wise. So yeah, this is my first try ever. I obviously don't think that it looks good at all, but still, if anything, it makes me want to get better at it so that I can actually paint what's in my head, because yeah, going for a painting and having the result to be something super distant from what you envisioned, it's kind of frustrating, so I want to get better. But yeah, this piece was also a lot of layers of ink to try to get the right values. It didn't work out so well, but still I think you can see what I was aiming for. Also at the end of the video you can see a little animation I did with the painting. It's something very simple, I was just playing a bit with color and with the lights of the little windows on the castle. But yeah, I think it looks kinda cute, so that's it for today. I hope you enjoy the rest of the video and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye bye!